Good morning, everyone. I am Vipasha Maholya, and today we'll start with a new unit, which is air pollution. So basically, it is a very important chapter to study, as we will see like there continuously growing in air pollution, water pollution in the earth, and we have to study what are the chemicals which causes air pollution, and it affects the plants to us humans. It causes various diseases to us. So and how to manage this pollution, how to reduce these pollution, what is the scientific reason behind that causes the pollution? Okay, so let's start with the first definition of what are pollutants which causes the environmental pollution. So presence of one or more air pollutants or contaminants in such concentration and duration that the life in the biosphere is affected is referred as air pollution. Okay, air pollution only occurs when some pollutants, they are above the standard limit and it affects the biosphere around it. So only then it causes the air pollution. Okay, so to further study what are the various air pollutants, let's study the various layers around the earth's surface. So as we see, this is atmosphere. What are the atmosphere? So first layer is lithosphere layer, then hydrosphere. Lithosphere, it is the basically crust of the earth. Then hydrosphere, it is the water. We see surrounded around the earth, oceans, rivers. Then first layer is troposphere layer, up to the 10 to 15 kilometers above the earth's surface. It is first layer is troposphere. Okay, then stratosphere layer, it lies in between 30 to 40 kilometers above the earth's surface. Then mesosphere and thermosphere. Basically, we are considering when the air pollutants are mostly present up to the troposphere layer, that is up to the 15 kilometers above the earth's surface. Okay, so this is the biosphere. Now, various categories of air pollutants are, number one is primary pollutant and number two is secondary pollutant. So what are the primary pollutants? Like for example, oxides of carbon, like carbon monoxide, carbon dioxide, these are emitted in our automobiles, okay, from industries also. Second primary pollutant is oxides of nitrogen, nitrogen oxides and nitrogen dioxide, okay. Third one is oxides of sulfur, sulfur dioxide, sulfur trioxide, then lead, heavy metal. It is emitted in automobiles, cars, scooters. Okay. Next one is hydrocarbons, then hydrogen sulfide, hydrogen fluoride, ethyl and methyl, or they combine ethyl and methyl, they are combinedly called as mercaptan. Okay, so these are emitted in industries, various industries, and H2S is, we see in sewage treatment plant, H2S gas is released. Then secondary pollutants, what are the secondary pollutants? Like H2SO4, sulfuric acid, ozone layer, these when primary pollutants combine with the moisture present in the earth's atmosphere, they form the secondary pollutants, like sulfur dioxide or sulfur trioxide. When combined with water or moisture present in the atmosphere, it forms sulfuric acid, and which causes acid rain, damages the your crops, and it decolorizes the marble, and aesthetic appearance it disturbs. Okay, ozone layer, it is a secondary pollutants. Formaldehyde and peroxyacetyl nitrate PAN. It is a very important thing which is normally asked in competitive exams. Okay, so PAN is peroxyacetyl nitrate. It is a secondary pollutant. Now some important points. Dispersion of these pollutants into the atmosphere, it depends on prevailing temperature, pressure and wind condition. So dispersion of these pollutants basically depends on temperature, pressure and wind condition. Okay, now next is, with increase in height, temperature of the air decreases. above the surface of the earth in troposphere, and troposphere up to the 15 kilometer, okay, above the earth's surface. And the rate at which this temperature decreases with increase in height is referred as environmental lapse rate. Environmental lapse rate is an important term which is defined as, like, with increase in height, temperature of the air decreases. जैसे जैसे आप एक height पर पहुंच रहे हैं, temperature जो है हवा का वो कम होता है, और जिस रेट से ये टेम्परेचर कम हो रहा है हाइट पर पहुंचने से, इसी को हम कहते हैं इन्वायरमेंटल लैप्स रेट, ELR, एंड इट इज इक्वल्स टू 6.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर किलोमीटर. एक किलोमीटर हाइट अगर आप पहुंच गए तो तुम्हारा टेम्परेचर हवा का 6.5 डिग्री सेल्सियस कम हो जाएगा. ओके, सो दिस इज द एनवायरमेंटल लैप्स रेट. जस्ट लर्न दिस टर्म, ELR equals to 6.5 degree Celsius per kilometer. Okay, for Earth, when the pollutant rises into the atmosphere, its temperature also decreases where there is no exchange of heat, and the rate of decrease of temperature with increasing height is referred as adiabatic lapse rate or ALR. Like, let's repeat this line. When the pollutant rises into the atmosphere, its temperature also decreases where there is no exchange of heat, and the rate of decrease of temperature with increase in height is referred as adiabatic lapse rate. जैसे जैसे आप height पर बढ़ रहे हैं atmosphere में, तो वैसे वैसे pollutant अगर height पर बढ़ रहा है तो उस pollutant का भी temperature कम हो रहा है height के बढ़ने से, जहां पे कोई हीट एक्सचेंज नहीं हो रही है. ठीक है, कोई हीट एक्सचेंज नहीं हो रही है, तो उस जो पॉल्यूटेंट का टेम्परेचर घट रहा है हाइट बढ़ने से, उस चीज को हमने बोल दिया है एडियाबेटिक लैप्स रेट, इट इज ALR. एंड फॉर वेट प्रोसेस इट इज 6 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर किलोमीटर, अगर आपका वो वेट प्रोसेस है. एंड फॉर ड्राई प्रोसेस इट इज 9.8 डिग्री सेल्सियस पर किलोमीटर. Okay, so depending upon the relative magnitude of ELR and ALR, following types of environment are being defined. So I'll show the just name. So various environmental are being defined. What are these? Unstable environment, stable environment, neutral environment, and more are coning, looping plume. Okay, under the neutral environment there are some more: looping plume, neutral plume, coning plume. So we'll study in our next lecture what are these. Thank you.